Festive mood here. You're wearing a orange and black Halloween tie.
My Halloween tie, boo.
I'm a little scared. I think the Falcons should be scared of the Saints offense. And speaking of the Saints offense, they lost a key player for the season, Heath Evans. Is he an integral part of the offense, and how big is the loss?
Oh, absolutely. He's an integral part of the offense. Blocking back like Heath Evans, the experience that he has, yes, it's a big loss, but it's not overcomable. We brought another back in from Philadelphia. Kyle Echol is his name. He's going to have to take some time getting in. They might put Lionel Hamilton in there in that spot. But, hey, at this point in the season, you suffer your losses injury-wise and you move on. Now, he will be missed, but he'll be around the locker room, and his leadership will be a big presence for the team throughout the season.
Let's talk about a former Saint. Aaron Stecker signed with the Falcons this week. Can he help them kind of decipher the Rosetta Stone and explain the Saints' offense to the Falcons, or is too much being made of the conspiracy theory behind his signing this week?
I would say simply that too much is being made of that. They may ask him some questions, there's no doubt about that, but I think he was really brought in because of the injury to Jarius Norwood, whose status is questionable, and they really needed the depth. So Aaron will help them out in the backfield and also in special teams.
Can you just talk a little bit about the Saints offense going against the 25th ranked Falcons defense? Not a tremendous defense, and one thing somebody pointed out to us is they have smallish cornerbacks.
Yeah, well, you know, certainly Colston and Henderson and the rest of our guys, and Colston in particular, will fare well against these guys. You know, the biggest problem for Atlanta in the defensive backfield right now is they just lost Brian Williams. Brian Williams was their starting corner in their main defensive set and also their nickelback. So they essentially lost two guys. So they're rebuilding the chemistry in the defensive backfield, and Saints certainly have an edge in that regard.
Reggie, earlier this week, a question was asked to Sean Payton about him being phased out. 7 touches against the Giants, 6 touches against the Dolphins. Is he being phased out?
I don't think Reggie's being phased out at all. I think Reggie is a unique back in that he's very versatile. He has specific uses for this club. And I think you're going to see Reggie make some plays going on this season. We're only six games into the season. He hasn't had a bust-out game yet. I think he's probably due some point in time. And he, again, he's an integral part of this package, running back and receiver.
You played for the Saints for almost a decade. Talk about this rivalry. It's one of the ones that Saints fans look forward to, Falcons fans look forward to.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know what? It's not only a rivalry of two NFC South teams. It's also a rivalry of two cities regionally. We go there, they come here. It's been big since I played ball, before I played ball, and it's still a big rivalry. But it's rivalry of the cities, too, the cities of the South. Who has the bragging rights for the NFC South and the southern cities?
And finally, Brad, a prediction. We ask you every week, and you've been correct because you pick the Saints every week, and they're 6-0.
Well, I'm going to be a homer again this week. I think the Saints take this game. We've got to put pressure on Matt Ryan. We've got to win the game in the red zone. Most importantly, that's where the Falcons have been their staunchest on defense. So we can do that. I think we'll put points on the board, and I think we match up well against this club.
And Brad will be joining us for our pregame show 6:30 Monday from the floor of the Superdome. We'll see you then.
Thank you. I'm looking forward to it.
All right.